Good morning again, my framing is coonies and everyone else, and also dogs. It's 1 o'clock in the morning. Hello, welcome to the plug. It's the 9th of October, Tuesday. I'm about to eat a food and then see where the evening takes me, aka into editing land and beyond. That was dramatic. Also, 10 out of 10 shares ABBA cover album. Are you kidding me? What are you doing if you haven't heard it yet?
Oh, she can't believe her. Look, I invited her. I love you. You're so pretty. Yes, and smart. Yes, and clever. Yes, all those things. Yes.
First, we're gonna do cheeseburger and Honeycrisp apple, the very last Honeycrisp apple in the whole store of Whole Foods. Rip.
Hey, buddy. How are you doing? Yeah.
And I also got okra in the oven, trying to stay on top of my meals.
I've got a lot of little cute doggies, including the biggest cute doggy in the whole world.
Well, it's like 6 a.m. I just took the girls potty. Now we're all hanging out in my room. Try and eat some organic gluten-free oatmeal. I tried to eat regular oatmeal last week and it did not go well, so I'll let you know how it goes. Greetings, I'm outside. The puppies are puppying, Murphy is Murphying. I am lemonading with hydration solution in it. And that's all I got. I'm just resting. Also, I'm supposed to go to Tennessee on Friday, but there's a hurricane coming, so I'm just kind of like waiting it out, watching the radar until tomorrow. Really, truly decide if I should reschedule my ticket for just like a few days later, not like postpone it by ever. Who calling me? It's lunchtime. I've been resting and I'm about to eat this bowl of macaroni and cheese. It's cashew cheese, but I'm excited. That's literally it. Hey there. It's 10:30 p.m. I woke up around 8 o'clock. Go me. I'm just like in the weirdest mood. A few things. One, mental health. So much better than it was last week. Like, it's literal night and day. Two, watching good old Below Deck, the regular Below Deck with Captain Lee. If anybody else habitually watches Bravo, please DM me at your earliest convenience because I need Bravo friends. I'm about to eat some onion rings and some cheeseburgers, which I will show you right here. And then one more thing. So Iris is starting to get the hormone smells of becoming in heat and Levi is beside himself and whatever couch she's sitting on chewing something, he'll just hump the couch and look at me like, and it's so cute and I just have to gently discourage it, but it's just really funny. Briefly, those of you who asked me about training for fatigue crash, I want to do a whole video on it, but like until I have the energy to, here is what you need to know. You need to determine your biggest symptoms of a crash, the most dramatic symptoms, which shows the most. Like, is it your heart rate going crazy? Do you get a fever? Does your blood pressure drop? Do you have some kind of like external bodily physical reaction? Like the biggest one or two? Those are the ones that you're gonna work on your dog recognizing. After that, you want to have the dog perform an alert cue. Levi has a few levels of alert cues. First one is just like giving me a hard stare down, like, and like snuffing or chuffing or putting his head down on me. That to me says, you need to be paying attention to your body right now. That's how I know, like, initially something's wrong. Okay, so once you determine the physical symptoms, then you have to teach the dog the alert cue. Like a paw, or like Levi lets out a little woof if I'm not listening, or if we're in an environment that's loud, like where there's a hairdryer going or something. The third level is him just like completely jumping on me, clamoring me, and trying to hold me down like from getting up. And that's how I know it's like 100% a fatigue problem. But if he's boofing at me, like one or two boofs, like not, I'm not talking about demand barks. These are looking in dead into my eyes and going woof, woof. And so like that's how I know it's an alert. It's totally different from like potty. Like potty is like, please take me home. Like, you know what I mean? It's totally different. Whenever you feel those symptoms coming on, you have to pay attention. You have to be mindful. Like write it on your hand, or put a sticky note on your forehead, or put it on your phone background to constantly be mindful of that symptom. And when you feel like it's coming, or when you know you're gonna exert yourself and you're gonna have PEM and you're gonna have those symptoms, when you know they're gonna come, have the dog come over, perform the alert cue. And then it'll take you like maybe up to 4 months to consistently get an alert out of your doge.
Who came to see me? Look who came. Look who came to love me. Hi, honey bun. Oh, my baby girl. I missed you today. Sleepy girl.
Welcome to resting land, where we have a simultaneous positive and negative attitude. I'm just editing. It's 3 o'clock in the morning. I found Casper Meets Wendy on YouTube, the full movie, so that's where I'll be for the next couple hours at least. 1 hour and 30 minutes and 0 seconds. Thanks for watching Vlogtober. Okay, bye. You guys rule. Sorry there weren't more dogs.